You look like Rory Amo.
I remember I was out with my friends, right?
Word.
And this girl was there, and she looked at me, and she was like, I don't know how to explain it, but you look like Jesus and Miro at the same time.
See?
I'm like, all right, relax like with the race. Yeah, she's like, you're mad racially ambiguous. I'm like, all right, relax.
Yeah, that would have turned me off. I would have been like, I don't want to talk to you no more. I'm using all these terms and words, like, yo, I'm where was y'all? Like, I'm trying to get smacked, and you're talking to me about some bullshit right now.
You went to Bronx Community College. You're talking like you're from Columbia. I don't like it.
Bronx Community College is like eighth grade. It gotta be like eighth grade.
It's time for your BAT starting five. From Southside, do or die, your tribal princess, Ms. Suku. From the 718, right off the Deegan, the man with the silkiest do-rag, Money. Our guard from Virginia by way of Europe, he gives his all every week, Cody Gray. Live and direct from Strong Island, the certified good you, Sky High Eve. From the barbershop, there's nobody who can do it like he does, Mouse Jones. You're listening to the Black and Out Table.
Fuck both of these niggas right there.
You mad, bro?
I'm perturbed.
Yeah, shouts to Ice Spice. That's what I should change my name to instead of Blem Shamrock. I'm going to change my name to Ice Spice Stan. Counts.
You a munchie?
Perhaps. Matter of fact, I'm gonna just do that. Boom.
That works.
But yeah. Shouts to Ice Spice, shouts to Cardi B. Bronx women are running the rap game right now. Feel me? Shit is incredible. We run the wrestling podcast space.
Been doing that.
Niggas hit the Juicy hand simultaneously.
Word, that was crazy. Big shout out to you, the listener, by the way. You know what I'm saying, for tapping in. Y'all know the real what's going on right now.
Name every listener right now.
Oh no, we can't do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, we global out here. You know what I'm saying? Can't do that. I'll be going for days out here, man. And I gotta drop for that.
We global now. We global.
You feel me?
Real.
Had to turn my AC off. That shit was humming.
Oh, thank you, Eve. Thank you. Look at Eve. Professional.
Imagine not having central air.
I thought you grew up in the Bronx.
Yeah.
Illuminati. I'm from the streets.
What is central air in the Bronx, man?
The Bronx.
A box fan in the window.
Yeah, they think it's a windy day. That's what they think central is, or just a windy day.
Just the front door being wide open in the building.
Catching a nice trip.
Nah, let me chill. I was about to violate, but I got love for my people from the Bronx, man. I was about to be like, yo, central air in the Bronx is just a homeless nigga farting.
In the Bronx, they think Central Air is the rapper that was rapping with Drake for that freestyle.
Nah, niggas made Juice come out, nigga. No,
yo, oh man. That's the energy we need to start this show. You know what I'm saying? Because if not, I don't know what I'd do. I'll probably do this. Nah, let me chill.
Thank you.
As you could see, if you could see that, there is a little bit of Corona left at the bottom of this bottle. I did try to finish it all, but it just won't let me, so. Cha.
Yo, you a different nigga, bro.
Yeah, though. Yeah, I'm not going front. I'm about to make a big boy move probably in like the next week or two. I'm gonna go.
What does that even mean? Oh,
I'm about to explain. Big boy moves only. I'm about to get a Costco card.
Mm.
Oh, gotta drop a bomb for that.
I don't got the
one drop
no more.
Ooh.
You ain't got the Sam's Club?
Yo, don't yeah.
Ain't no Sam's Club where I'm at. My fault. Ain't no Sam's Club. I mean, I got BJ's, you know what I'm saying? But Costco is the elite.
BJ's is kind of mid though. Like BJ's, you think it's gonna be better, but there's nothing really there.
Yeah, nah, the quality, BJ's quality, like it's good for now. Like it's man. Convenient, you know what I'm saying?
I thought I was gonna be a fan of BJ's, but they just built one by my house. I mean, it's all right, but BJ's aren't really like they don't got everything.
Yeah, no, I don't got everything the way Costco do.
Yeah, Costco's different, bro.
Bro, Costco got the freshest produce, the freshest like livestock. They got snow crab legs, furniture, MacBooks, caskets. I could literally get anything I need from Costco, yeah. Bro.
Sam's Club got oxtail now. That's pretty.
They do?
And for the low.
Speaking of oxtail, go on.
I was just going to say, I seen like it was like a 6-pound pack of oxtail for like $40.
Yeah, not the 6 pound for $40?
Yeah, it was a good deal. I looked at it. I was like, if I knew how to make oxtail, I would have caught, but you know.
Oxtail ain't that hard to make, honestly. I made oxtail this past weekend. Mm-hmm. It was fire, to be honest with you.
Yeah, nah. Eve, show the people your hands real quick. Those are the hands of a West Indian auntie right there. All right? The picture that he sent to those oxtails. I was like, there's no way the man who mixes cement for a living can make oxtail that looks like that.
Yeah.
See these hands? You feel me? Come on, bro.
Those are the hands of an aunt that gives you $20 when you see her.
Here, go. Mad loving.
Yeah.
I'm not going front. I made that shit on Sunday. Fire. Rasta pot. And the funny thing is, I made all that shit for the very first time ever in my life. You know what I'm saying?
Where'd you find the recipe?
Nigga, I am the recipe. Nah, nigga said, where you find the recipe? Come on now, brother.
I'm impressed.
You feel me? Come on. You think a man like myself with all this knowledge?
I thought you went to Martha Stewart for the recipe.
Look where you going for oxtail.
He hit up the Rachel Ray cookbook like, all right, how do I make Rasta pasta?
Yo. A million pounds of heavy cream. Now I made Rasta pasta too. I made all that for the very first time. That shit came out spectacular. Wow. I ain't gonna front. The oxtail was type expensive though. I was trying to get the fresh joints. Niggas was charging me like $25 a pound. I was like, you niggas is on drugs. Boom. Ain't no way. I had to get the frozen joints. It was like $15 a pound. Bought £2 worth. Took them home, seasoned them up, and made them the next day. Man, I had to cook them for like 3 hours, but it was worth it.
I love it, man. Shouts out to Eve one time.
Hey, next time, I'm not even going to bullshit. I was about to be like, yo, I'm going to start a cooking show on the Patreon. I am not starting a cooking show on the Patreon. Feel me? I do fucking enough on that shit. Tap in. But I might, like, whenever I do cook, I might throw it in the close friends just so, like, niggas can see, like, yo, look what's popping in the kitchen today.
You have a close friends?
Hell yeah.
I have to start one, bro.
I ain't posting it in a long time, but I do have
Look at what the men of this generation are doing. Alphas like me, we can never.
Alphas.
Nigga, <it's laughs>
we put that shit on the main story.
He said alphas. This is your alpha right here.
Yes, sir. Manny Tate. Manny Samuels.
Yo. Oh, nah, that's what I wanted to do. I was trying to pull up the video of the USPS dude flinging your package to your door.
Nigga violated.
Yeah, nah, I wanted to pull it up here just so we could, like, talk about it briefly.
Oh, man, we got video footages of Manny getting violated.
Oh, bro. My God.
Next time I see this, yo, I'm swinging, bro. I'm throwing a hammer at the head. Pause.
We here. Hold on. we getting it loaded up?
Is there a way? Let me see if I can pull this thing up, man.
Oh, yeah!
You want me to DM it to the Twitter?
Oh, yeah, you can do that. That could be easier.
All
right. Yeah, nah, this nigga violated, son.
Make sure the sound is on, though, by the way.
Don't worry, ladies and gentlemen. We're getting the footages right. Ready.
Yes, footages on the way.
Footages are sent. Confirmed, right. Bro. Ooh. Next time I see USPS, it's on site, bro. All
right, let's
go. My mom showed me this video. She thought it was me. And I thought it was me, too. But I'm like, wait a minute.
Look at what you be doing.
No. Put the volume all the way.
Wait. Damn.
You can hear the camera sound. You can hear the camera sound in the video, bro.
Yo, what did you do to this dude to make him violate you like this?
I ain't do a goddamn. It was some pants. I caught some pants.
Oh, lucky boy.
This girl told me I should hit up USPS and be like, they broke my package. But I'm like, it's pants, though. And she was like, tell them it ripped.
Levi jeans. Nigga caught some Levi's.
Bro, he flung that shit like a fucking frisbee for no reason. He was already at, put the video back up. He was already at the steps.
The nigga flung Levi's, son.
He was already there.
Yo.
He better than me. I'll be doing the same exact shit.
Bro, look at this. Bro, he was right there. Look.
Nigga.
And then took a picture of it.
Pictures too.
Yo, you had to have done something to this dude.
Wait, let it run. Let it run. I think in 3 seconds he was gone. After he took that picture, threw it. Look. 3 seconds.
Boom, gone. You hear the snap?
Yeah, you do.
Look. Bro, he's an ass. I better never see this nigga, bro.
He making moves, nigga.
Yo, I have seen niggas' packages get violated, but that was hilarious.
But like, why fling it when you're at the door? Like, bro. If you're going to fling it, fling it from deep. Fling it from like 10 feet out. Pause.
He could. That is crazy. But he could have like underhand like tossed it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
bro, he literally
frisbee that shit.
Yeah, he let that shit fly.
Nigga threw your jeans at the door and bounced. What a guy.
Jeans.
Man, I'm sorry.
I don't even want to wear the jeans no more.
Let's do a live unboxing. Show us the jeans. Show us the jeans.
Leave my jeans.
Premium content, ladies and gentlemen.
You feel me? I'm gonna write these off now.
okay, some Micah Mary.
Nigga got Ghostface jeans at 04. Nigga, them shits look big as hell.
Nah, they just like folded weird.
Oh,
you feel me? Some, you know. Oh, wait, nah, they did rip.
Some Kasubis.
I'm about to send this picture. Look, they ripped my jeans. I gotta try these on after though, by the way.
Yeah,
nah, these some flare denims. You know, I'm trying a new look.
Okay, I respect it, man.
We finna see.
Turn it up. Man, shout out to you, Manny. You always this is what Manny does to the show, man. He brings his life into the show and gives us his trauma, his pain in our opening segment of the show.
Yeah, I'm like Larry David.
Well, that means we all have our drinks. It's time to get started, man.
Right. Yo, shout out to Body More Bottles before we, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Before we get, you know, things. Oh yeah, let me show some love. Gotta show some love, of course. You know what I'm saying?
I don't got my cup on me right now, but I needed a real tall glass today. So,
look, man, this is episode 294. Thank y'all for joining.
Journeying.
Look, man, we gonna make it light. We gonna knock out what we need to knock out, because we'll be right back with you guys live right after SummerSlam. The live poll show, we're going to break everything down on SummerSlam live on our YouTube. Y'all, please tap in and join us. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
We here.
And with that being said, I guess we could jump into the next segment.
All right, y'all, check it out. We got 5 Patreon tiers, okay? We have the dollar tier, which is just $1. It's a donation. We have the $5 tier, which is audio and Discord access. We have the $10 tier, which gets you audio, video, Discord access, and a discount on merch. And the $20 tier is for the ballers. You get all of that, plus you get to be on one of the shows that's on the Patreon, all right? Subscribe to the Patreon today. Become a patron. I'm Eve, and I approve this message. We out.
The Block and Out Table.
Yes, sir, man. Yes, sir.
Hi, weirdos.
Yes, sir, man. Episode 294 of Black and Out Table Podcast. Right now, man. News and rumors, where we hit you with the newest and the latest. What's going on in the wrestling world? It's only right we let that news fly.
Let that news fly.
And with that being said, man. News and rumors, man.
We here.
Yeah, yes, we are.
We are indeed here.
I want to give a big shout out to the Elite. You know what I'm saying? The Elite is staying all Elite. You know what I'm saying? They announced they renewed their contracts with AEW. And to those people who thought Kenny Omega was WWE bound after the contract, you know what I'm saying? It was a little motion in there. The rumors in the past, how WWE was shifting their focus, trying to sign Kenny Omega. I'm sorry, those dreams are done. The Elite stays all Elite. You know what I'm saying? They all keeping their executive vice president roles and everything. So, hey, I'm pretty sure they got good money, good position in the company. Why not stay there? It's cool. Shouts out to them.
I was gonna ask that, like. I feel like when they first started AEW, they made those roles seem like it was way more important than what it was. Mm-hmm. Is that still a thing? Like, because remember, I felt like they announced that Kenny Omega was in charge of the women's division. The Young Bucks were in charge of the tag team division. And Cody was in charge of, like, the main roster or the men's division type of shit. Is that still a thing, or
yeah,
was that just some bullshit they were selling?
Nah, they stay like those are real roles, and we've seen it play out during the whole CM Punk situation when he got into it with them with those guys and everything. Mm-hmm. And CM Punk was like, how the EVPs keep leaking information to these outlets and everything, and that kind of started their whole thing. So, and behind the scenes, Kenny Omega is still playing a big part with the women and everything, so that's still ongoing, it's a real thing for them.
I just wanted to make sure because I wasn't sure. Like, I haven't heard anything about them being EVPs like in a while. So
I haven't heard nothing either. But I'm not gonna say, I'm not gonna lie. Seeing this today did ruin my whole. Because I did want to come in here on my Brian Windhorst shit. Because I seen the Cody Rhodes documentary. Where's my pen at? It makes it more official. There we go. I seen the Cody Rhodes documentary yesterday. And there was a lot of Matt and Nick Jackson all throughout that documentary. And like the, you feel me, like the second half of it.
Yeah.
And I was like, yo, could it be? You feel me? What if? We, you know, we've been hearing rumors about them, him, them and Punk, you feel me? The contracts. I was like, what if this is just a, you feel me, one of them things from Cody Rhodes? You remember when MJ retired and Scotty was on the Bulls talking about, yo, come back, MJ, putting up the shoe? I was like, what if this is one of them things? And then today they re-signed. And I was like, damn it! I was wrong.
Wait, I got a drop for that? Do I gotta? No, I don't. I could just play this.
Wait, so were the Young Bucks? They were in the doc, like being interviewed.
No. They weren't being interviewed, but it was a lot of like behind the scenes footage, like being the elite footage, shit like that.
So okay,
They were like, I was like, could this be a potential play? I was wrong.
Yeah, I gotta catch that doc.
I mean, since we're here, let's talk about it. Being Cody Rhodes, I think it's called. The doc on Peacock. What a doc, man. And nearly 2 hours long.
Jeez.
Eve, I'm going to let you continue since you started on it. Go ahead.
Hey, man, the documentary, it was a lot of propaganda. It was a lot of Cody propaganda in that doc from start to finish. I'm not going to lie, but it worked. You feel me? It made me look at the nigga. I'm like, yo, this is the greatest nigga of all time. So I'm like, the nigga tore his pec, came back to work on it. You feel me? He over here sending voice notes to Triple H. Like, yo, please, OG. They said my shit can't break no more, OG. Please let me rock. I'll be there on Sunday.
They played the actual voice note, which is funny.
Hell yeah. My boy sounded broken too. I was like, damn. This shit crazy. It was the perfect amount of like emotion, behind the scenes shit, like true life. You feel me? Like it was the perfect amount of everything. Like the story that they told in it. I was like, damn. I was like, nah, this nigga Cody, man. This nigga really is something. Shit was crazy. I'm not gonna lie. But I want to say the part that stood out to me the most was the part where Cody Rhodes was like, yo, I was so fed up like doing the Stardust shit. Like, he was like, I was so checked out. I would come to work with like a, he said he used to have like a, you know, the shit that niggas put coffee in, like that big ass like canteen.
The thermos.
Yeah, he was like, I'll pull up with a thermos full of whiskey and Gatorade and drink on the top. I was like, yo, I stood up and started applauding. I was like, yo, this nigga, man.
You think he me?
Facts.
The word. I told Eve.
Nigga, I don't do that.
Merch, nigga. Hit WWE shop one time. He got some new shit on here. Like that hit home, man.
I was saying, nah, this nigga is the greatest, bro. Nigga just in the back and catering, drinking whiskey, getting tore up.
That's the life.
He said he didn't even care if he didn't care if he got caught, got fired. He didn't he just didn't care.
But do y'all remember I remember that was like around the same time I became like a fan. That was what, like 2013, right? 2013, 14, when Stardust became a thing.
Around that time, I'm
sure. Yeah. Because I remember I was seeing it and I was like, this is stupid. Like, it was nothing like cool about the character. He wasn't even doing anything crazy. The best thing he did was that match against Cena in like 2016.
Mm-hmm.
But like that Stardust shit dragged on for way too long.
Way too long. And at first with the Stardust thing, everybody was like, oh, it's like Gold Dust, you know what I'm saying? It was like cool for like a quick little moment thing. Mm-hmm. But like you said, it dragged on way too long.
because they did, didn't they have matches against like the Shield when the Shield first started?
Mm-hmm. And that's they beat the Shield.
Yeah, and then like, bro, and I remember 2016 for the IC, not the IC, the US title when Cena was having like the open challenge or whatever. I'm like, bro, this shit is enough, like, you know, but yeah, and then he ended up getting released and became who he is now. So I guess he kind of needed it, but still.
Yeah, man, it was like the ultimate, like, yo, bet on yourself story. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like it really showed you, like, yo, like, but he kind of, like, he had to bet on himself, bro. Like, and even, like, the risk that he took, like, you look back at it now, like, yo, this nigga's bugging out. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, to leave the security of the of a WWE job to go out to wrestle in damn gymnasiums and shit, coming from where you were.
Yep.
Starting your own damn company to rival the biggest wrestling promotion in the world, like, nigga, that shit is insane to think about.
Nah,
and it started when he made that list. Remember, like, when he first got released, he put out like a picture of a list of like the people he wanted to wrestle.
I remember that list. I gotta go back. We gotta go back to that list and
let me go find it. Just,
but it's like that whole documentary, like Eve was saying, like, it's the whole bet on yourself thing. Like, you know what I'm saying? The thing that caught my attention was his relationship with Dusty, you know what I'm saying, with his pops and everything, and him and his sister going out and pursuing acting, and Dusty sold a Rolex and gave them $10,000 each. Wow. Like, yo, go ahead, pursue your dreams. Like, that's I found out, like, that's some real dope shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, fam, I'm over here doing commercials, trying to just to not get payments on the cars and everything. It's just like, fam, Dusty, it gave me more insight to Cody's relationship with Dusty that I didn't know of. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And how close they really, really were.
I think Plies did the same thing with his kids.
I'm sure he did. He said on Randolph on the Plug twice. Gave my kids $2 million. I do tell them, do what your daddy did, something like that.
I love that song.
I remember that.
Give him $1 million piece.
Yeah, give him $1 million piece. Tell him, do what your daddy did.
one of the greatest. Apple Music thinks that's one of my favorite songs ever. every month he goes, oh, would you want to listen to music like Randolph on the Plug twice? I always say yes. The list is in the Twitter DM, by the way, if y'all want to go over it just to see how it panned out.
Let me pull it up.
But as you pull it up, yeah, man, this is the ultimate bet on yourself documentary. Here we go. We got it up right here. This nigga got Moose on the list. That's what stood out when I seen it in the doc. I was like, look who on his list.
Who is Bola?
LeBron. Battle of Los Angeles. No, that's Bola is the PWG Battle of Los Angeles.
Okay. The Miracle Moose. Does that say Pat Buck?
Yeah, who's that?
He got fired from WWE.
I think. Yeah, it was like Pat Buck used to work backstage.
Yeah.
Shibata, Trevor Lee, personal ring announcer, Roderick Strong.
All right.
That's a list. Like, looking back, that's a list and a half.
It is, man.
Shouts to Cody for this list, man. I should make my own list.
You got to post it just like that.
You don't want to make my list. I got a list too, but I can't. Bernice. I can't fulfill that to the public. Exactly.
Meg Thee Stallion, Bernice, Dream Mariah the Scientist,
Danny Lay. I got a list. Hold on. Speaking of Danny Lay, I hear this drop in a minute. Yeah, shout out to Granny Lay.
Coi Leray.
Ooh.
Let me get to writing this list real quick. Hold on.
Yeah, nah, my list would be crazy, son.
Yo, speaking of Danny, speaking of Danny Lay, didn't she run over some niggas and like she?
It was a little DUI, nothing crazy.
All right.
Shame. You got that drop that him.
Oh, I know.
That was Danny Lay running over.
We do not encourage drinking and driving on the pod, by the way.
Yeah, we don't.
We just encourage Danny Lay. That's it.
He had to leave, but had to leave. It's just the timing for me. It's the timing. Oh man, but yeah, man, that was a great documentary, man. If you guys haven't seen it, please go and check that out. We recommend it. Let's go. We have a couple of more TV situations to get into, man. WWE, they was on Family Feud. I didn't see the full episode. I did see the fast money round with Big E and Seth. They ended up winning money for the charity. So big shouts out to them, man. Big shouts out to the E holding it down. Very entertaining.
Facts.
I got a question about this though.
Shoot.
At what point do you start making money where you're okay with it going to charity?
I don't think I'll ever be to the point where I start. Like, if I let me give this shit to charity myself, you feel me? But if I win it, I want to, you know what I mean?
Don't give my 50 bands to charity. Yeah, give them 10. Give me the 40.
Word.
Yeah. Nah, for real, that's a roly, nigga. That's what, you know what I mean? I could be, you know what I mean?
With you the telling young me Alexa kid. Bliss don't need 50 bands?
Or is she about to have a kid?
Yeah.
You got Dolph Ziggler there? You know, well, I ain't gonna violate because Dolph been employed for a long time for the E. So in them,
come on, it's Dolph.
It's Dolph. Yo, Dolph. Dolph Ziggler, salute to you, man. You've been holding down the job, and I ain't seen you in years, my nigga. I salute.
He's the modern day JTG.
When shouts out to fellow Black Announce Table alum JTG, by the way.
Cause he held a job. He stayed with that fucking job for a minute.
He did, but I'm gonna say this: Dolph Ziggler, JTG is two different situations. You know what I'm saying? I think more props goes out to JTG than Dolph Ziggler. I'm gonna just say that.
Yeah, I think JTG like a whole tech nigga, bro.
Go say that. Tell us more, please.
I seen this nigga, it was last year. This nigga's Instagram, like when Kevin Samuels died, like you would have thought this nigga was like, you would have thought the nigga knew him personally. So I'm like, this nigga was distraught, bro. This nigga was like, yo, rest in peace, King. We'll never have another one like you. I was like, yo, what's up with you, bro?
You sure that wasn't Banks?
I'm not mad at that. I'm not mad at that. That probably was. Yeah. I'm not mad at that. I see it. Yeah, that's probably one of, like, you know what I'm saying? He probably, Kevin Samuels was a thinker. You know what I'm saying? His way of thinking was very different than, you know what I'm saying, everybody's. And JTG probably, you know what I'm saying, was tapped in like that.
He probably was. It was just funny because he would do Masculine Man Saturday or some shit. He'd be like, every Saturday as a man, you must go outside and let the sun hit your face. You must be barefoot. I was like, boy, what kind of shit is this, JTG? But shouts to him.
JTG was saying that?
Bro, yes, man. It was all over his shit.
Yes, man.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of
my mouth? Yes, oh, man.
Y'all are ruining crime time for me, bro.
There was a joke right there for me, but okay.
Hang on, yeah, yeah. And we're going to get to the other television aspect from the WWE, man. Let's get into it, man. First take, Roman Reigns, Paul Heyman appeared on First Take.
Paul Heyman went a little too crazy. I'm not gonna hold you.
How so?
Oh, my fault. Why is he on ESPN talking about God doesn't hear my prayers?
Yo, like, Paul Heyman was wilding, but he was letting his nuts hang. Oh my God, Stephen A. brought up Mean Gene,
Bobby the Brain.
Oh yeah, yeah, he brought up Bobby the Brain. He was like, "He's dead. So what?" I was like, "Hi."
And then he and Stephen A.'s like, "Oh my God," he's like, "God doesn't hear my prayers. Keep talking."
Yo, you seen Molly and Stephen A.'s face when he said that? They like, like, "All right,
so you can say that." But nah, Stephen A. knows you can say that because he was wilding on Elvis like 2 weeks ago. Like, yeah, he was like, Elvis, who by the way is dead. No, I was like, yo, Stephen A, we know Elvis been dead, bro. Like,
nah, Paul Heyman be wilding, bro. I remember somebody asked him about Chris Benoit. He was like, sure, he was really good in the ring, but fuck him. I'm like, there we go.
Swag.
He's like, you want me to say something nice about him? I'm like, bro, some of these wrestling fans be fucking bozos. Morons. Like, yeah. Oh, but he was a great wrestler. He's like, yeah, okay. Fuck him.
Exactly.
Yeah, shout out to Paul Heyman, man. He gets it.
White Plains legend.
Who, me?
Hell.
You know, I met Paul Heyman actually because I live in White Plains. I think he lives in Scarsdale. So I used to go. This was in 2020 when I was losing. Oh, here we go on me. It's in 2020 when I was going to the gym like twice a day and I would get like green juices at this market. And one day I go into the market and Paul Heyman is right there online next to me. And I looked at him. I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to say anything. I'll meet him another day. Never seen him again.
All right, man. Let's remove you from the solo layout.
never seen him again.
Yeah, should have said what's up.
I didn't, bro. This was like during the peak of COVID, so like I was scared. I'm like, yo, if I say something to somebody, do we die? It was still dangerous. But I'm sitting there, and I'm like, this was when they were doing it in Florida, the shows in the PC.
Yeah.
So I'm like, I don't want to mess this up or anything. So I'm going to just keep my distance because this is when him and Roman first started. So I was like, bro, if I got COVID and I give it to Paul Heyman, that fucks everything up. So I took one for the team.
Shouts out to Manny.
Nah, ain't no shout outs, nigga.
No?
Ain't no shout outs for that.
No shout outs to Manny for giving us great television.
Yeah, I put the fans on before myself.
Yo.
But one day we're gonna talk to Paul Heyman. We're gonna have a whole conversation about this moment.
Yo, Paul Heyman, please come on the show, man. I got questions.
Please.
Should I start going to that market every day just waiting for him?
No. No. But that would be a hell of an interview. So Paul Heyman, matter of fact, we gotta hit our people and make that happen.
Word. I'm ready to do another interview. It's been a minute. I'm over here like, ah, yeah, I'm ready.
For that real interview. Not no mysterious shit.
I'm ready to get back to it, pal. Nah.
Y'all not trying to interview, what's the new fucking Roman's cousin? Umaga-san?
Nah, I'm good, G.
I actually do want to talk to the nigga, but it's like, ain't much to talk about right now.
Yeah, no, he hasn't really.
Because I don't.
He just started.
Yeah, I don't know much. I'm like, that's why I gotta round up my questions.
I'm not trying to be like, so what was jail like?
And you would definitely ask that question too, regardless. Yeah, even if you're not trying to be that person, you would still ask him.
I don't gotta ask him. I know what it's like.
All right, man. All right, Dominic Mysterio.
Oh my god.
So did you have the top bunk or the bottom bunk? Same nigga, I am.
Yeah, that could have went a completely different way. I thought he was gonna say something else. I'm happy it was that. I'm happy it was that. But
I'm out of here.
I'm happy it was that. I'm gonna say that.
You crazy, bro.
Yeah, man. On Paul Heyman, Roman Reigns on First Take. Brilliant shit, man. How about Stephen A, man? Stephen A, he wanna come to the E, man.
Yeah, this time we gotta make it happen, man. One way or another, we gotta figure out how to incorporate Stephen A. Smith into the WWE and make it seamless.
I need him to flame the Street Profits.
Actually,
wait, whoa.
It might be an easy transition, but go on.
We go get to that. We go get to that. Because, boy, do we got some shit to get into about that. For real. And by the way, listeners, you heard it here. Black Announce Table first. You heard it here first. And now you're seeing it come live on your television screens. That's all I got to say.
What did I do?
But we going to get to that. We definitely going to get to that.
I did a thing?
No, not you, Manny. I mean, you ain't do nothing. This have nothing to do. This literally has nothing to do with you, Manny.
I'm lost.
Good. Good. That's fine. You know what I'm saying? Yo, wait, hold on. This has nothing to do with you too, Manny. But don't you hate niggas that got to be in tune with everything? It's like you hitting your man. Yeah. Like,
nah, this got nothing to do with Manny, but Manny.
Nah, it's just like, nah. Yo, remember, like, yo, you ever tap your mans and be like, you talking to your mans and then your other mans becoming, what y'all talking about? You talking about that? Like, bam, no, nigga, this got nothing to do with you. AB combo right now. Just chill. Like, you good. I'm sorry, that.
I used to hate when niggas tell me that shit back in the day. This is an A and B conversation. See your way out. Like, fuck you. Fuck you and this conversation.
Oh my god.
Nah, that's a fact, nigga. That's why I always minded my business. I see niggas talking out like, I ain't trying to get violated. I'm cool.
I just stand there and act like I'm not there at all.
Yeah.
Put my head down.
The only thing you gotta say is like, what happened? And then they confirm whether they want to let you in or not. Like, be like, nothing.
Just wait till they say your name. Yeah. Just wait till they say your name.
Word, that's crazy. Try to move yourself, insert yourself into the conversation. That's wild. Hey, nigga, get the fuck out of here, nigga.
See, that's how I know I'm socially awkward. I don't interact at all. I just literally just sit there and just wait. Like, right, Manny? And then I'm like, oh, yeah. Oh, y'all talking to me too? I wasn't even listening for real.
Meanwhile, you done heard every damn thing.
Ain't got thoughts on it.
Word. You ready? This nigga ready.
That shit's real.
Oh, shit, man. That's real shit. Real shit. one more thing before we move along with other topics that went down in this segment. Another TV, you call it TV thing. It's on YouTube. It's TV, I'm guessing. Ariel Helwani, he did a sit-down interview with Kevin Owens that was released today. Today being the day we recorded this. And might be a hot take. It might be. I might be a prisoner of the moment. I think this was the best. Matter of fact, I can't even say it's the best. I think this is the one. This is the Ariel Helwani sit-down I enjoyed the most. It's just like Kevin Owens, he comes off as so real. He comes off as so down to earth and just honest. Like, you know what I'm saying? He doesn't take credit for anything. You know what I'm saying? Ariel Helwani tried to give him his props for being a part of this Bloodline storyline. He's like, fam, like, the only reason why I'm in there, I have a 20-year history with Sammy. Like, I have nothing to do with this. He was just praising everybody else. And he was basically saying, like, he's been lucky his whole career. Like, he got called up to the main roster because Cena wanted to work with someone new. Like, the roster was all shot. Cena handpicked him. Like, yo, I need somebody new to work with.
And that was also in 2016, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And Cena just picked him up and he worked with him. He said he became Universal Champion because Finn got hurt. And you know what I'm saying? They had the Fatal 4-Way. Roman wasn't ready to get the title put on him. They had other plans for Seth. Big Cass wasn't ready. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, he's just showing love and he's just like honest about everything. You know what I'm saying? And he said that he felt the Usos and him and Sammy did deserve the main event WrestleMania. But other than that, he's just like giving it up to like everybody else. This was real dope. Like he's just been completely honest. So if you into these sit downs, like how I'm in touch with these sit downs, this is a good one to watch. So I would recommend it.
I'm gonna check that one out tomorrow at work.
Yeah, man. This is good shit. Good shit. And he also like said, like, yo, having these tag team titles, like with what the Usos done, having the longest reign and them putting them in the main event at WrestleMania, he feels like their championship reign currently is not living up to it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's just saying, like, yo, I got a long ways to go with these championships. You know what I'm saying? They main evented, got over all of this stuff, and we weren't even on the card at Money in the Bank. And obviously, they're not on the card now because he's hurt. Yeah. At SummerSlam, but it's just a whole lot of like KO giving it up. He giving it up in the sit down. So this is dope. This was dope.
I gotta tap in. I like interviews like this because, like, again, like even the interview that he did with the Usos, these are people that we barely get to hear from.
Exactly.
You know, saying like you don't get to really hear from KO like that. Like we heard a lot from like Bianca. We heard a lot from like Charlotte. We heard a lot from like even like Roman to an extent. Like we hear a lot from him, but like people like KO and the Usos, it's like, yo, you don't really get to hear them speak like that. So to hear them, you know, give it up in an interview or just hear what they have to say, period, is pretty refreshing. So that's something I'm going to definitely tap into that tomorrow morning.
Ariel is a great, like, wrestling interviewer.
Mm-hmm.
Like, to be honest, if I'm all of these other so-called journalists, you got to pack up the title. Like, yeah. Ariel has been doing these interviews for maybe 2 years, like for real. And he only does them for like the big pay-per-views.
Body.
And these people have been around for fucking 15, 20 years, longer, even like for Dave Meltzer and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't do shit, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
And you got Triple H doing interviews with Ariel before that UK card. The Usos, all these people. You're telling me none of these people ever wanted to talk to anybody before?
Like, that Triple H interview was probably my favorite one that he did.
Amazing interview. He talks about like almost dying and how much like that had an impact on his life and shit like that. Like,
X.
Come on. Ariel has been killing it.
Yeah, nah, Ariel's amazing, bro. Ariel Helwani, you are the wrestling journalist, man.
Whoa, we gonna that's what we doing. Dave Meltzer ain't there no more. What's the nigga name?
What has Dave Meltzer actually done?
What's my nigga name that he with Brian Alvarez?
Nah, it's Raj Ariel Helwani 1, me at number 2. Then everybody else is after me and Ariel, man.
I'm rolling.
Ariel at 1. Tyrese Simon. Shouts to Tyrese. He interviewed him. I'll put him at 2. Then
So you're talking about Gibson.
Matter of fact, you're right. I'll put Tyrese Gibson at 3. And then I'll put myself at 4. And us 4 are the Mount Rushmore wrestling journalism.
That's crazy Mount Rushmore.
I still don't understand the whole wrestling journalist thing. Like, does Law and Order have a Dave Meltzer? Like, is there somebody ranking the episodes 5 stars?
Hmm.
Like, what are we, like, when you really think about what they're doing, it's so silly.
I blame y'all for that. Because why y'all, like, fam, y'all take this man's word as gospel. That's why we have this podcast. You know what I'm saying?
This is to the hood for my criteria.
This is the real. We giving it to you the real way. This is not like, as Eve would say, white man paperwork. No. And that, like, that ain't that. Like, this ain't that. This is the real.
You could come here for an unfiltered opinion. You feel me? I'm going to give it up. I'm going to tell you how I feel. And that is what it is. You feel me? You see this pen right here?
No.
I talk with it when I want to make serious points. And this makes me officially a journalist. So everything I say when I have this pen in my hand is true.
So, like, how many of the five-star classics are going up at the barbershop that Dave Meltzer is giving, like, a five-star rating to?
Barbershop.
Because that's really where you get
a Dominican barbershop, an Italian barbershop, a black barbershop.
A Dominican barbershop with two black barbers in the front.
Okay.
Now, one in the front, one in the middle. And there's five seats.
So three Dominican barbers and two black barbers.
Yeah.
You lost me. Y'all lost me. Mm. Get to the point. Y'all losing.
I'm trying to say, like, if you show it to, like, because the barbershop, I feel like, is the main consensus of what people would actually watch. Like, they'll put on some movies that you wouldn't really watch on your own time. But then when it's on in the barbershop, you're watching it and you're invested now. You know what I'm saying?
Shit is fire.
So that's a question right there. Which, if you had a wrestling match, I don't know if y'all taking it this way, but if you were in the barbershop, which wrestling match you would put on at your barbershop?
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Like,
okay,
what five-star classic would you show, or like a match that's considered a five-star classic that you would put on in a barbershop that you think would get people, like, you know, invested in watching?
Recent, it got to be like a recent joint,
whatever. Just you're putting it on just to see, like, if people are fucking with it.
One thing I know about the barbershop, especially the barbershops that I've been to, I know that niggas like controversy. I know niggas like wild shit. You know what I'm saying? The barbershop is the first place I ever seen Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift. You feel me? And it was hot when I seen it at the barbershop. I seen it at home on TNT. It was not the same.
And so, that's what I'm saying. The barbershop is a whole different experience of viewing.
If I had to show niggas in a barbershop one match, it gotta be Mankind and Undertaker, the Hell in a Cell joint.
You a genius.
Because that right there is, wow, you just seen a nigga get murdered two times. You know what I'm saying? Yo, and I already know the reaction when they see Mankind get thrown off the cell. You feel me? The nigga's gonna go up with the Clippers. Somebody's gonna get zeked. It's gonna be crazy. So that right there is what I'm showing niggas in the barbershop. Lock it in. Turn it up.
Cody. There you go. That was the match right there. That was the match right there, man. He mentioned something recent. He mentioned something recent. I mean, you said you asked, like, if it's something recent. Excuse me. Damn, Tito's taking a hold of a nigga right now. I had to slow it down. But
I pulled up my third Corona. I'm just looking at it like, yo.
I had to slow it down. I got too excited. You asked if it was something recent or not. But something recent, man, I bring up that Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar match at SummerSlam, man. Since we on SummerSlam, bring that up. Niggas see a goddamn forklift come out there and lift up the damn ring. Niggas is going crazy, like, and Tyson Fury there too to add some more shit into it. Like, yeah, the barbershop be feeling that.
All right, this one will stop all haircuts mid match. Hulk Hogan versus The Rock at WrestleMania. That's getting I'm telling you, that match.
Wait, hold on, man. I might have a drop for that. I might have a drop for that.
Oh my God. Bro, I'm telling you, the match is ass if you watch it with the sound off, but if you watch it in the barbershop, 7-star classic.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong. Match, over-delivered. I think that match is a classic. I think that's a classic match. It definitely over-delivered by far, considering The Rock and old ass Hulk Hogan. That's a and the crowd played a big factor in that. But at the barbershop, I don't know.
It's gonna get the convo going, because then they're gonna be like, oh no, y'all don't understand Hulk Hogan.
Big name, understand that. Go ahead.
Maybe even Rock, Stone Cold too.
Might be. I could see that.
Because you got to go with the name factors.
Yeah, the name factor is very key as well.
If I was to show him some new shit, it would probably be like some AEW shit. But I don't know what match like I would show him. Like, I'd probably show him like one of them like Young Bucks and what's them niggas?
FTR.
Other ones.
Lucha Bros.
Yes. I'll probably show him one of the Young Bucks and Lucha Bros matches. This is what the new shit. This is what the kids be on.
I've learned that like people do not like that. Like older people don't like that style. To them, it's too fake. Because they look at it and they're like, it's too much flippy shit. Like, it's unnatural.
It can be. It is. But the Lucha Bros are so nice. The Lucha Bros and the Young Bucks chemistry is like this. So the synergy is right. You know what I'm saying? Like, it may be unnatural to some, but the synergy is so, like, they so locked in that it's like, yo, everything is fluid. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, because I've seen people that like don't really watch wrestling. If they were to see like a match with like Daniel Bryan, Randy Orton, and Batista, they'd be mad that Daniel Bryan won that match. Because to them, they're like, "Yo, how you lose to? How does Batista lose to this guy?" Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, that shit pisses them off. It makes me laugh every time, but they hate that shit where the small guy wins.
Yeah, and I'm not gonna front. If you show niggas in the barbershop a picture of Ryback, they'll be like, yo, this nigga must be like the greatest nigga of all time. He's like, yo, how many world heavyweight championships this nigga won, man?
They'll be mad that Daniel Bryan got the push and Ryback never did.
You show him a picture of Adam Cole, they're like, yo, who is this, a baseball coach?
What is a little ass nigga?
This nigga a shortstop.
Last nigga. Like,
yo, we should do that. We should pull up to barbershops and just like have people rank wrestlers by how they look.
Yo, that's content right there.
Yo, nobody steal our idea too. I'll beat y'all niggas up, man. Real shit.
100%.
I didn't open this Corona for the sole purpose I could turn it upside down like this and back to your head.
I love that idea, actually.
That's real content right there, man. That's real content. We do have a top heavy show before we get into our SummerSlam predictions and we break down that card for y'all. I'm trying to debate on, do we have enough time to get into one of these topics, or should I move on to the segment that we like, you love, Indies Aren't Real, Volume 6.
Oh, let's tackle the topics and then get into it.
All right, man. All right. Look,
yeah, let's do the indie shit.
You gotta do the indie shit.
Topics are they? Let's see what the topics are.
Let's see what the topics are.
Look, man, I got Kurt Angle saying if he hadn't left WWE, he'd be the greatest of all time. I also have Matt Riddle. His issues outside of the ring have prevented WWE from pushing him as a top star. So on you guys, or we could just jump to Volume 6.
I could cover both of these in under 60 seconds.
Let's do it. It's on you, Eve. Let's do it.
Let me tell you something. First off, Kurt Angle, whether you stayed or you left, you was already the GOAT to me. You feel me? Because you the talent, And what you did, first off, you're Ricky Yan in WWE Undisputed. You know what I'm saying? You was there. I forgot. I think he won like six championships, six WWE champ, World Heavyweight Championships, whatever, in the WWE. Left, went to TNA as a drug addict, started wilding the fuck out. You feel me? This nigga was going crazy, having matches with young, now legendary talent, Samoa Joe, AJ Styles, Christopher. Like, come on. Like, what are we talking about, bro? That's not the greatest of all time.
No, because that's when he jumped to the other side. If he was still in WWE and stayed there, he would have been on the ECW brand. And but then you can continue his career from there.
On the ECW brand?
Because that's when he left. He was on there and then he left.
That shit died like 2 years later.
Exactly.
I don't even think it was 2 years later.
That's where he was at. He just didn't jump. Like, he jumped to TNA and then obviously went on the run. But like, he in TNA. Number one, he was, look, I'm going to break this down too real quick. Number one, he was on the ECW brand. You know what I'm saying? They put him over there. He had the wrestling machine gimmick, which was cool. Don't get me wrong. But once again, third brand. And the nigga was about to die. This nigga was fucking on drugs, OD. Like, fam, if niggas ain't let him go, this nigga probably would have died on Vince McMahon watch. And that's why they let him go, because Vince ain't want to have an Olympic gold medalist die under his watch like that. So,
but to his point was, if he never left, he would be considered a GOAT. I would still consider him one of the best of all time. Like, if his career ends before he goes to TNA, his run that he had for, what, 5 years, 6 years? Still better than most runs.
It is. And
typically, back then, that was how long a run would be.
But we don't consider him the GOAT right now.
Who would be?
Kurt Angle.
Yeah, I would, to be honest. Me, because I always loved Kurt Angle growing up. So, me personally, I would. And to be honest, if nobody does, they probably weren't. They were too young. Because older people have to realize that he was that good.
He's good. All right, my fault, Eve. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Like, don't get me wrong. Kurt Angle's great. But he's saying he would go down as the greatest of all time. And I don't agree with that. No. Because even like you're saying, like, if you cut him off at the time he left and went to TNA, he's still considered one of the greatest of all time. In ring, mm-hmm. we can all agree he is one of the greatest of we've ever seen in ring all time. Mm-hmm. He said he would go down as the greatest of all time. No,
I didn't know he said he would be the greatest of all time. I didn't know he said that. All right, I see what he means now.
Right. Yeah, nah, think about it. Well, I don't know. I don't want to say he probably would have died if he stayed in the WWE. Because they probably, I feel like they either would have fired him if he stayed.
Or sent him to rehab.
I don't want to say that. Wait, hold on. Don't say it like that. I ain't saying he would have died under their watch. I ain't going to say that. But
yeah, that is crazy. And me's calling him a drug addict as well, even though he was. But
like 18 Vicodin. 18 Vicodin is crazy.
Yeah. Nigga, what do I call that?
Yeah.
A pavilion? Yeah, all right, whatever, nigga. But Tim staying, I don't know if he would have died, but I feel like he would have either got fired because of all the chances that Vince gave him, or they would have tried to like force rehab. But before he left, they was trying to force him to go to rehab anyways. Mm-hmm. So I feel like either way, his career would have turned out the same way, either way, like. He probably would have got fired and went to TNA, or he got released, yeah. Or he asked for his release and went to TNA. So I feel like it probably ended up the same way.
If anything, TNA made him better, because look at who he worked with when he went over there. Like you said, the Samoa Joes, Christopher Daniels, AJ Styles of the world. Like some of his best matches weren't even in the WWE. And that says something to how good his matches were over there.
Is it true his run in TNA was longer than WWE?
Yes, that was another crazy fact that blew my mind. Because he came back in 2016 as well, I think.
It was like, so that was
10 years.
Yeah, if you add that, then I'm pretty sure then that's it might be longer than his run in TNA, but taking that away, because that wasn't a real run like that, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Which it's still crazy, by the way.
Yeah.
But yeah. Yeah. With that being said, Riddle, yeah, you on your own, my nigga.
Yeah, me not here.
Yeah, you on your own, Chief. Yeah. Like I said before, we like it, you love it. Indies aren't real. Volume 6. Let's get into it.
There was nobody in the room for that last video. He did that for 3 people.
Hey man, that nigga got stomped on, bro.
That stomp was fucking insane.
Yeah, I gotta get up and shoot the nigga after that, bro. Don't step on me like that, bro. We're supposed to work with UODing.
By the way, those Tim Rivera videos where they do the Subway Mania. One of my best friends is Jeff Hardy in that series. So, little fun fact.
Snicker, man.
Yeah, he took a 3D on the subway floor during COVID, and we thought he was going to die.
Man, you could have joined up and been Bubba Ray Dudley or somebody. Like, why are you?
I'm not touching the floor of the subway.
Manny, you gotta push the pod forward. You a member now. You gotta step out your comfort zone.
I'm not gonna pull up as Gable Stevenson.
We will get into that too, ladies and gentlemen.
It's not
Black and House Table. We don't shy away from anything over here.
Like I said, Gable Stevenson. Shouts to the Indies, man. I'm not gonna lie. This segment every week. Feel me? I may feel how I feel about my job, but at least I don't got to do it, y'all. At least I don't got to do that.
I ain't gonna lie. If I could do that and get what I paid now, yeah, I'd be lit. I ain't gonna lie.
They're saying the same exact thing as you.
I want to be a wrestler, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
Let's write these down. So I got, hold on, let me write this shit down, man.
I want to be a wrestler, bro. Eep, get your pen and paper, bro.
We've had very good ideas. So we have Manny Barbershop. Yeah, can I get a pen that work? God damn.
No, nigga, this is 2023.
All right, so we got Manny's Barbershop idea.
Okay.
You feel me? Don't steal this shit, too, because I know niggas out there, y'all be listening to this show, stealing shit. Cut it out.
Turn it up! All
right. Then we got Cody in wrestling school.
Turn it up!
Yo, I also had this other idea to put a microphone on Manny and record him while he goes speed dating, because I feel like that shit would be hilarious.
Turn it up!
What are the 3 tiers called for the Patreon?
Speed dates.
Speed dates.
What are the Patreon tiers called?
LeBron.
We would have to play the Patreon promo, but I'm pretty sure it's like the big Buford tier.
All right. So if everybody
hear me tier.
Yeah. everybody who's on the 5, if y'all upgrade to the 10, we can fund at least 2 of these ideas right here.
Facts.
So go ahead and do that. And we'll get these done.
Turn that 5 to a 10, you feel me?
Mm-hmm. What's an extra 5?
What is an extra 5, man? Add that somewhere where you can get some great content. You know what I'm saying? Look, man, this is what's going down. We're going to go into this week in wrestling next, and we're going to talk about a little things, and then we're going to break down the whole entire SummerSlam for y'all. You know what I'm saying? That's what we're about to do.
Let's do it.
Acknowledge me.
Rhea Ripley. The strongest, the fastest. I'm that.
I don't miss
This Week in Wrestling.
Yes, sir, man. This Week in Wrestling, episode 294, Black Announce Table Podcast. Y'all already know who you are, who y'all rocking with. With that being said, man, NXT, Great American Bash. It went down Sunday. What a match. I'm going to start right here, man. What a match with Carmelo Hayes, Ilya Dragunov. Oh, man. Woo! That's some heat right there. I could drop a bomb to that one. Let me drop a bomb for those boys right there, man. Some real dope shit, man, on this premium live event. And this was the match that I really wanted to see, me being a person that doesn't tap into NXT like that. But tapping in and just seeing this match right here, I was tuned in to the premium live event from the beginning. I was in and out throughout. But this match right here, man, this done it for me. And I see that's on the notes right now. Is this Carmelo Hayes' best match?
Bitch, it might be
this match. So I definitely got to check it out before SummerSlam. But
yeah,
from what I'm hearing, this might be his best match.
Yeah,
I'm not surprised because Ilya is a fucking beast.
Before we get into the actual match, what was the venue? What state were they in?
Texas.
You know.
Yeah, they went Texas.
I was actually shocked that NXT sold like an arena like that, to be honest. Like when it first started, I didn't even know it was gonna be in an arena. I thought it was gonna be in the regular PC or some shit.
Listen, man, WWE is a hot ticket and I'm loving it right now.
Thanks.
I'm loving it just for wrestling in general.
Mm-hmm. This is bringing back the old NXT vibes where they were selling out arenas for random pay-per-views that wasn't tied to like a WWE weekend.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So this was great to see.
Since we didn't see it, Carmelo Hayes, I think this is Carmelo Hayes' best match. Hands down. I really think it's just wonderful. This is a match of the year candidate. For me personally, Tiffany Stratton retained her championship against Thea Hall. Thea Hall is 19 years old, if I'm not mistaken. And
really?
And she went in there and she lost. They threw in the towel for her, but what a great showing for her. Like, this was great. She's got a great future ahead of her. That was dope. Dirty Dominic Mysterio retaining his North American Championship in the triple threat.
What do y'all think about Dom in NXT, though?
What do you mean? Just him rocking in NXT, just having that championship interacting?
Well, I don't get. Well, I do get, like, they're probably trying to get him, like, reps and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
But why this way instead of doing, like, dark matches? Why do you guys think?
Mm-mm.
You got to build him up in the public eye, man.
Yeah.
You got to legitimize him somehow. Yeah.
You have to.
But does NXT legitimize him more? Like, being on NXT legitimize him more than if he's working dark matches plus main show matches?
Yeah.
Like if he's doing dark matches against like whoever the fuck, and then having like a quick match on Raw or like a mixed tag match or some shit on Raw with Rhea on his team or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, which do you think does more for him?
I think he needs reps. And that's with anything. You need reps of doing this. And it's been since his run, since he first got brought into the picture, a lot of people were saying he needs to be in NXT anyway. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So now that he has this heat on him, every time he touches a microphone, he gets booed out the fucking arena. It's like, yeah, let's go to NXT, shine that light on them. He's just going to get the reps to be even better and better and better. Because like with anything, you keep doing it, you're going to get better. Mm-hmm. So this only, it helps everybody. It helps Dom. It helps who he's in a program with. Because they're getting the heat. Because Dominic is a heat magnet right now. Mm-hmm. So I think him being involved in NXT is fucking great for everybody. It's everything with Dom and NXT is perfect for me.
Especially with who they had in that match. You have Mustafa Ali, who would be the vet. You get Wesley in there, who he's like the next guy. And then Dom in there to get the reps with the experience with those two guys who, you know, Wesley's been on the indies for however long. So it was interesting to see this match and what they were doing with it.
Yeah. We had the family, Tony D and Lorenzo becoming new NXT tag team champions as well. Roxanne Perez defeating Blair Davenport.
The family, you know, by the way, they have my favorite storyline in wrestling right now.
Really?
Like Tony D'Angelo going to jail and then having all those promos and shit like that from the prison cell where he's talking on the phone and like, you know, he's having all these promos and shit like that from the cell. I loved every moment of that, by the way.
That's called realism.
Yeah, like I never thought I would see a wrestler in jail for some shit that he did. And like the build up to the match is him going, yo, I'm about to get out in a couple weeks. Yeah, I better. And then he's like, you know, moving the game plans and shit like that. I loved every moment of that. NXT got real creative with this one.
I ain't gonna hold you, man. Everything on this card was, I was rolling with it, man. They had the 8-person mixed tag match that was fire as well. That over delivered as well. But we got to get to it, man. We got to get to it.
I was waiting for you to say this match.
We got to get to it, man. Let's get right into it, man. Gable Steveson, Baron Corbin ended in a double countout. It was Gable Steveson's debut. And he was obviously supposed to be the babyface in this match, but the crowd was behind Baron Corbin, of all people.
They were a little bit everywhere, though. Like, at first, yeah, they hated Baron. And then in the middle of the match, they flip, and now they're cheering for Baron. And then the finish of the match happens, and, like, everybody's mad, so now they're definitely cheering Baron. I hate that this match had to be what it was.
Yeah, they didn't know what was going on.
Yeah, bro, it was fucking stupid. I'm watching, and then I'm like, I see the count out. And then the no content. I'm like, bro, what are we doing? This was right before we ended up potting Eve.
Yeah.
But I'm watching this shit. I'm like, bro, this is the debut that you give. But in my head, I'm like, oh, maybe they use this for the future when Gable's like, oh, you know, I had the worst debut ever. Nobody really liked me, and I had to be a star. So,
but we know why the debut was that way. We know why.
Tell the people.
I don't know if we want to bring that to the main page, but yeah. Gable Steveson's accusations. He was charged with something and it was dropped due to technicalities, or I'm guessing. So a lot of people feel like he got off on these accusations due to technicalities. Mm-hmm. So I feel like that's why the crowd turning on him. And look, WWE, you got a tough road ahead of you. I'm gonna just say that. With all of these accusations and his situation y'all got going on with there, but
yeah.
I'm gonna just say that.
Speaking of accusations,
we ain't gotta speak too much on it.
You know, but also, how many times are you gonna do a wrestler who, like, bro, Kurt Angle, Chad Gable, Jason Jordan, fucking, like, bro, every wrestler you have to give the same exact gimmick, every single one.
I mean, I'm an Olympic gold medalist. What you want me to do?
Got a point. My swag.
I seen it already. It also didn't work when I seen it already, and they had to make him a heel because I seen it already. Like, what are we doing? There's nothing really to like about Gable Stevenson anyway. He has no redeeming qualities.
He haven't give you nothing to like. Like, he got out there on NXT and it's just like, fam, he needs a lot of work.
Yeah, like 2 weeks ago, I seen him cut a promo with some white dude and he was like, we're going to train and be ready for this match in the, what's that shit called that they're doing?
Karate?
It was like remember when Raw had that Raw Underground shit? They're doing like the NXT Underground version of that, and they're like, yeah, we're gonna train. And then they did a montage. Bro, it was the worst montage I've ever seen in my life. They weren't even sweating. I'm like, bro, what are we doing here? It was terrible. Bro. Then I look and now he's having a match with Baron.
Look, man. We ain't even got to dive too deep into it.
So we off the Gable Stevenson train?
This is your man's.
I'm just tired of saying that, of people saying I look like him.
This is Eve man's, though.
I was high on Gable Stevenson. You talking about allegations. I don't know what this nigga's allegations are.
Oh, you want me to bring it up?
Hey. You can. They not my allegation. I ain't do nothing.
Yeah, I don't know if we should bring up allegations that were dropped, because
I just want to know what it is, because I really don't know.
Oh man, please.
You know, trigger warning.
It's rap, the R word. It's the R word. I just say
okay.
It's the R word.
Yeah. It's rap with the E at the end.
Yeah, they got dropped due to technicalities.
The fuck is a technicality?
Hey.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Black Announce Table Podcast. We talk about wrestling here, not stuff like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? I'm sorry we can't go into detail about that, but if you want us to go into detail about that, tune into our Patreon. You know what I'm saying? Y'all can go there, and we might can put something up for there, and you can pay for it.
Listen to that on Audio Dre, nigga. I ain't talking about that. Nigga, you talk about it. I ain't talking about that shit.
I'm talking about Audio Dre. Drop is crazy.
Audio Dre, hold on. Do I got my Audio Dre drop? Don't worry about it. I just play my name.
Cody Dre.
Right, look, it's a reason for me to hit my name drop. But look, we're going to move right along, man. How y'all feel about Trish and Becky being left off the SummerSlam card?
Good.
Manny, how you feel about that? One word.
Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Yeah, I caught him. I caught him, yeah.
I was gonna say it makes sense, but
no, because I didn't, because Eve was about to go into it, but I give my one word answer and then I'll let Eve go into what he's about to say. Mm-hmm. I think it's good too. You know what I'm saying? I think it's good too. Eve, go ahead.
Nah, hey, look, man. This, first off, to me, I feel like this has been going on way too long, anyways. I'm not that invested in this feud. I haven't been invested in this feud for a very long time. This should have ended when the whole Lita thing ended. Like, I've been over this shit, to be very honest with you. So, the fact that we don't get to see this match at SummerSlam, I am pleased. I'm very happy about that. Because guess what?
It also means more.
In many ways. You feel me?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Manny. What you mean? What you say?
Yeah, not. It means more. Like what Eve said, like he was going to go to the bathroom during the match. Bro, if it's on a Raw, where is it? In Montreal or it's somewhere in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So they announced that match in Canada, Trish's home country.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it means way more over there than it would on SummerSlam in a card that's already like, it's either stacked or there's, you know, enough mid to where you're like, I'm not even going to care. So if you main event it on like a Raw, it means way more to the match than it would be on this pay-per-view, this match specifically.
I think that they fucked up. I'm going to keep it 100. I think they fucked up because obviously if because Trish came back to get her match with Becky, she turned heel for the match with Becky. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And it was supposed to be at a big pay-per-view. It was supposed to be at SummerSlam. I honestly think they really didn't understand that the matches they have on SummerSlam, they got a lot of matches on SummerSlam. We got 8 matches on SummerSlam. You know what I'm saying? And once again, we have the women's champion, world women's champion, Rhea Ripley being left off the card. We have the undisputed tag team champions being left off the card, although due to injury, but it's still being left off the card. And that's still a lot of matches on this card. I think that they thought that they wouldn't have these matches fall into place like this.
Mm.
And they would they thought they would have some space for it. And they didn't. And I'm glad they didn't shove it in there because I don't want a loaded card. I don't want an AEW card. I don't want that.
Here's 4 minutes. Go have a match.
Yeah.
Like, it's way better that they're doing it the way they're doing it.
They're going to do it like this, and they're probably going to main event Raw. Or, you know what I'm saying? They're going to get a lot of time on TV. I like it like this. So, listeners, viewers, watchers of the show, don't be alarmed. This is a good thing. This is definitely a good thing if you're invested into the Trish and Becky feud. And also, one more thing. This goes into how far Becky has fallen. And no one want to say it. No one want to say it. We like Becky, but this goes into her stock and how far she is falling. Because Rhea's obviously, right now, Rhea's number one.
Mm-hmm.
All the women right now, Rhea's number one. And she's not even on the card. She's not even on
Yeah, I was going to say, is Becky even number two?
I don't know. Oscar, I'll say the two top women.
I'm putting Oscar over her.
I'm putting the
and
women.
And Bianca Belair.
I'm putting the women that's on the card in the championship match. Mm-hmm. Let me say that. In the championship match, because there's another another women's match on the card.
Mm-hmm.
But those women are ahead of her as well.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? You just got to look at how the cards end up being dealt. So,
yeah,
that's a good
Becky,
point.
Becky, she needs to find something. Like, you know, it's not what it was 4 years ago, 5 years ago when she first started. Like, people are catching up. You know, she did lap a couple people, but now
that's
the
good.
The women's division's catching up, and there's people worth, you know, seeing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's the best way to say it, but yeah,
I don't think that's a bad thing. Like in the overall look of things, but it goes to the fact she has her stock has been falling. I don't think it's bad, but her stock has been falling. Let's be honest.
Mm-hmm.
Well, has it fallen or have people gotten better?
Both.
I would say both too, but either way you slice it, you know what I'm saying? I think
hey, at the end of the day, only one person could be at the top at a time. At a time, you feel me? So,
yeah,
you've been at the top for mad long. You know what I'm saying? Like, now we got Rhea, we got other women that's out here doing their thing. and they killing it. You know what I'm saying? So she got to take the obvious step back. And I think that's okay. And I think she doesn't mind doing that. You know what I'm saying? Like, based off of what I've seen, and, you know, I think Becky is a team player, unlike somebody else.
They mad, though.
You know what I'm saying? Who is they?
They throwing little shots like they tight. They being left on SummerSlam. Ooh, Becky and all Trisha. True. They throwing little shots. They throw, if you've been tapped into the tap-in, they don't seem like they the happiest being left on SummerSlam.
Hey, man. Well, I did not tap it. I did not see that Woj bomb. Hey, man. Becky, look, just relax. You know what I'm saying? Go out. I don't even know where they – where's SummerSlam? Detroit. Go out to Detroit. You feel me? Have a
look
blast.
Look up T-Grizzly.
You feel me?
Look at who you hooking up with. What, you about to play GTA? Man, I'm cool.
Check in with Big Sean.
Big Sean.
Look who you're checking in with.
But yeah, man. Becky, you be all right, man. Wait, this is a good thing that this match isn't on the card. I'm happy. You should be happy, too. You got a day off.
And that's a fact. Just support Seth, man. Just support Seth when he lose. It's all good. We're going to get into that as well. Couple more things before we move on, man. I noticed we've been dragging along real quick. Mello and Trick. They separated.
Finally.
They separated. And go ahead, Eve.
Nah, what happened? I missed this.
Nah, they separated. Mello and Trick was backstage. They was in the locker room. And Trick was just like, yo, yeah, you the champ. I got to do this for myself. I got to be the man. Like, I'm not a sidekick. Like, he was just saying all of this stuff that was just, like, real shit. Like, yeah, you the man, but I have to do this for myself. I got to go out and be my own man. They didn't turn on each other and none of that. It was just a separation. Like, Trick going to go out there and be his own man. Carmelo going to hold it down as the champ. And they said they love each other, and then they separated. And I love that shit. I love it. That was just a great move for WWE to not have them like turn heel on one another and turn up. Like, nah, like, yo, Trick been getting called out and been getting cheap shotted and all of this stuff. Let me go out on my own. I got to do this for myself. You already champ. I got to prove myself now. And I loved everything about that. So it looks like Trick is separated from Carmelo. This was dope how they done it. It was dope. Like, listeners, if y'all ain't see it, check that out. Just how they separated. That was dope right there.
Hey, I'm going to say this, man. This is what everybody needed. The fans needed this. Carmelo Hayes needed this. Trick Williams needed this. You know what I'm saying? For the longest minute, we've been clowning Trick, saying that he's basically a weed carrier for Melo. He don't do nothing. He's out there. You know what I'm saying? And we was clowning Melo too, because for a minute, Melo, like, it felt like having Trick there was kind of stifling him. You know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, why, you're a champion. Why you got your mans out here helping you? You know what I'm saying? Like, it looked odd. It felt odd. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, I felt like, as a fan, it was like, all right, bro, like, Trick, we can't have this no more. You know what I'm saying? So I'm glad that they split cordially. Everybody went their separate ways. They still homies. So, you know, salute. Shouts to friendship.
Yeah, dig. Shit, legendary, nigga.
Man.
I got that drop. That's a OG drop. Yeah, man. Like you said, like you were saying, that was dope. Real dope shit. Two more things I have before we can move on. Mm-hmm. I don't know if y'all want to add. My nigga Rey Mysterio was legitimately injured on SmackDown with a concussion against Santos Escobar. You know what I'm saying? They stopped the match. I know a lot of people were saying, like, it's part of the storyline. Like, no, it didn't make no sense for it to be part of a storyline. But Rey Mysterio got a concussion. They stopped the match. They awarded Santos Escobar the win. So he'll go on to face Austin Theory for the United States Championship.
I'm shocked they caught that, by the way.
What you mean?
When I was watching it, I was trying to see like where he got hurt or like what happened. Mm-hmm. And like you couldn't really tell. So the fact that they caught that, shout out to them, because if this was 10 years ago, 20 years ago.
Facts.
Now he hit his head on like once he dove, like he leaned back, his head hit the fucking back mm-hmm. of the mat outside. His head hit the shit and gave him a concussion.
I'm not laughing at that. I'm laughing because I'm thinking, like, yo, I wonder if I ever had a concussion in my life, man.
I did. I slept it off.
I know I did. Nigga, I was playing football in the park, nigga. I caught a little nice little route. Boom. I caught the ball. Little brolic nigga behind me, boy. That nigga tackle me, boy. That nigga laid me the fuck out. I ain't know where I was at for a smooth 15, 20 seconds. I'm like, man, where am I right now? He was some brolic little, like, I'm in Virginia. So, niggas, you know he was a little brolic nigga. He laid me the fuck out. I remember that shit still. I was like, fam, that was scary. I'm like, yo, I don't know where I'm at right now.
Yeah. Meanwhile, I was drunk in Turks. Sleeping it off.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got CTE, nigga, because of that.
Me and Antonio Brown are basically the same mentally.
That's crazy. You know what, Manny? We gotta do this to you right now. Hold on. Let's take you off the screen right now. Remove you right now. I'm scared.
You need to put him on the Summer Jam screen.
Matter of fact, let's add Manny back and let's do this. Yeah, man.
All right, let's ask Manny a series of questions real quick.
Word. Let's put him back on the
image. Tomato.
Yo, I'm not even about to ask the question no more. That told me everything I need to know.
I have a picture of me sleeping off the concussion, by the way.
Look, man. Have it based off that answer.
I know nobody cares. Karrion Kross has a new finisher. I know no one cares that
it's stupid.
Oh,
but it's a pump handle into like some fucking shoulder carry
into like, an F5.
Is fucking do it to the Big Show.
That shit is mad work. Yo, I'm not, yo, if you try to hit a nigga with that move in 2K, I have mad time.
Triangle.
Bro, to reverse that, I have mad time to reverse that shit. It's so much setup. Bro, I could reverse that into like a swinging neck breaker or some shit. Or a reverse DDT. Like, come on, bro. Let's be real.
Y'all not rolling with him trying to be original with something?
Man, look. It's not cooked, man.
Trying to be original isn't an excuse for being a dumbass. Like, when you're doing the most, nobody gives a fuck.
That's a fact.
And he's doing the most.
I'm surprised. I thought y'all got like, yeah, at least he trying to be original with something. He ain't no, like, he got an RKO finisher or some. All right.
I like the guy. I think he's cool. He looks cool. His girl's fire. But
repeat that one again.
Exactly. So, you know, the fact that his move is fucking stupid pisses me off. Because it's like, it's another reason for people to hate him for no reason. Because I do feel like he gets a lot of hate. And like, I never understood where it came from because people fucked with him when he first got on the roster. And then Adam Cole cooked him and he's never been the same.
Yeah, nah, it's been downhill since.
Who was fucking with this nigga when he came up?
Now, when he first came up, everybody thought his entrance was fire. The song was fire. His girl was fire. Everybody was rocking. And then, like, two matches happened and nobody was rocking no more. It was over.
Who the hell is everybody? You got to put me on with everybody.
Now, it did piss me. When I found out that he was bald by choice, I did not like this man.
I'm not going to lie. It was a few things that did it for me. One, it was the Adam Cole thing. Two, when I seen him beat Keith Lee with a back body drop, I was like, what the fuck is that?
This nigga's amazing.
Three, when Braun Strowman cooked him on IG in his comments, calling his Hellcat a V6, I was like, all right.
I ain't even know that.
I was like, Braun Strowman, see, everybody's clowning you.
And 21 Savage liked the comment.
That's crazy. I was
like, bro, when everybody clowns you, nobody's like showing you no type of respect. How do you expect me to even fear you or show you, you feel me, like, or take you seriously? These niggas don't take you seriously. You know what I'm saying? So I just can't. Ever since then, you feel me, I've just been off the nigga. You know what I'm saying? Then, you know, all of that mixed with like the QAnon shit that he was on.
Oh, he was?
And, yeah, he was on like some QAnon shit a couple years ago.
Wow.
And then I was like, nah, like every time I see him, I'm like, he looked like a cop, like an undercover nigga. So I'm like, yeah, I'm off this nigga, man.
He's also Puerto Rican.
But not like South Bronx Puerto Rican. He's like, he's New York Puerto Rican that moved to Orlando.
Nah, he's like the New York Puerto Rican who becomes Italian when they're a cop.
Yeah, yeah, that kind.
Yeah, like they have an Italian accent, but their last name's Rivera.
Sad. But anyway, yo, I don't know if. Well, obviously, we're about to do the predictions. I don't know if is the Battle Royal a part of the SummerSlam card, or is it on SmackDown?
It's part of the SummerSlam card.
Alright, so we gotta talk about it because I have a theory.
Oh yeah, no. Every like that's why I left off the matches that's involved with SummerSlam. I didn't even talk about them in this segment, so we're gonna get into that. I guess this is a perfect time to get into that then.
Hell yeah,
let's do it. Let's do it, man. SummerSlam predictions. We here, ladies and gentlemen. This is the moment y'all been waiting for, motherfuckers. Get into my bag, man. Yes, and before we go any further, we will be live right after SummerSlam. Live post show is going down. Don't worry, we're going to break the show down brick by brick, layer by layer. Y'all can get your favorites, opinions right after the premium live event. You know what I'm saying? And with that being said, we're going to do something different. Y'all was telling us how much. Wait, this is for our Patreon viewer, by the way. But y'all was telling us how much y'all spend on the betting and everything. That's what we got. We got the odds for y'all. You know what I'm saying? We got the odds for the SummerSlam card before we get into our predictions right now. Y'all tell us if this is valid for people that want to put money on the card right now. You see, I'm going to pass this off to Eve right now because Eve knows what everything's going down. This is the main event right now. The Roman Reigns-Jey Uso match. Here's the odds for it. Eve, tell us, is this good right now? Is this accurate in the words of DJ Khaled?
Yeah, all right. So it's all right. It's showing me Jey Uso for plus 700 and Roman Reigns, heavy underdog. I mean, heavy
favorite.
Minus 2,000.
Is this realistic? Without giving away your prediction just yet.
Yeah, the Roman Reigns favorite part. Jey Uso plus 700. I don't know. I don't know if I'm feeling the plus 700 for Jey.
Manny, how you feeling?
I'm trying to look just to see a comparison of just to see if this is accurate or not.
Oh, Manny. Oh, you one of them. You one of them.
I'm a gambler for real.
You know what? I say the plus 700 might be accurate because that's something I'd see. And I'd be like, you know what? I'll sprinkle a little bit. You feel me? A little cheese on Jey Uso just cause. You feel me? I throw $5 on it.
Well, here's the rest of the card. These are the odds.
Brock Lesnar plus 500. Underdog? That's crazy. Ronda Rousey plus 425. That's great.
Listen, listeners, we giving y'all an exclusive of Parlay Next Door. You know what I'm saying? No, this is an exclusive right now.
These numbers are actually accurate, by the way. I just looked it up. These are basically the numbers, yeah.
Yo, niggas have Ricochet at plus 500 underdog. I'm not mad at that.
I would take a flyer on Ricochet. I'm not going to hold you.
But Logan Paul minus 1,000, though?
That's the only reason I'm taking a flyer on Ricochet. I'm not mad at Ricochet's odds.
I'm going to spend a couple more seconds on this.
Whose odds are realistic? I feel like...
The unrealistic odds here would be... Maybe Brock Lesnar being that much of an underdog?
Yeah, I'm looking at that. That's crazy. That's why I said...
Plus I would have assumed that it would have been like even. It would have been like... In betting world, and Cody, in the betting world, even is like minus 110 both ways.
Yeah,
both ways.
I did a mistake. I did a mistake, ladies and gentlemen. I should have played this after we made our prediction. So that's on me. You know what I'm saying?
We made predictions?
This is the first time we got this graphic. You know what I'm saying? So that's on me, ladies and gentlemen. My apologies.
I'm such a sick individual that I'm looking at these numbers and I'm like, yo, I'm over here calculating. Like, yo, if I threw X amount on this nigga and tied it in with this, like, I'm over here doing the beautiful math.
Look. If we not doing that, we not doing right there. We not doing
that.
Graphic
right back up, man. Pull that graphic back up.
No, man. We got to get into these predictions. I'm going to bring it up after, man.
I ain't about to do no TTMN tonight, man. Fuck my life. I'm tired.
Look, man. Let's get right into it. Let's make these predictions, man. Like I said, we done dragged it along enough for you, man. We have the SummerSlam Battle Royal. This was announced on Friday on SmackDown. The only confirmed participants are LA Knight, Sheamus, Tommaso Ciampa, Shinsuke Nakamura, Otis, and Chad Gable.
We know who's winning.
Do we?
Yeah. Yeah.
But he should win.
It's but LA Knight. Let me talk to you.
LA Knight needs to get this win, man. You feel me? I'm gonna lock him in as my pick for this, and then I'm gonna say this. I don't want LA Knight to keep like losing and it get to the point like I feel like his saving grace is that this isn't like a championship match. You feel me? And that, like, right now he's not in a position to where, like, he should be facing for, like, a world championship or anything. You know what I'm saying? Like, the U.S. title, like, that was a couple weeks ago, and everybody was like, yo, he should be going for that. But after, like, we got past it. You know what I'm saying? But I don't want it to get to, a point or a situation where it's, like, the Braun Strowman thing, where he was hot as fish grease, and they missed the ball. They dropped the ball with him. And then when they finally put the strap on him, like, nobody gave a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Or the same thing with Shinsuke, where it was like, the nigga's hot as fish grease, wins the Royal Rumble, loses at WrestleMania, and then that's it. So, hey, I just want them to, like we said a couple weeks ago, do they need to strike while the iron is hot? Yes. Is the iron hot right now? It's heating up. I'll say that. But do not miss an opportunity with this nigga, man.
LA Knight is... number one selling merch. He's number three selling merch. He's number four selling merch. He's number five selling merch. Hey, man. The SummerSlam Battle Royal. We don't even know what does the winner get. Look, give him the victory. Thanks. I'm tired of betting on LA Knight and him losing. But guess what? For this SummerSlam Battle Royal, there's no stakes here. Fuck it. Why not? Give him the victory. I'm going LA Knight.
Hell yeah.
All right, so Manny, you got LA Knight as well, I'm guessing.
Yeah, no, I started it by saying I want him to win.
You actually did. You actually did. All right, man. We're going to move right along to the next match, and that's Ricochet versus Logan Paul. And I'm going to start this one off. I'm going Logan Paul. Logan Paul is due for a victory. It's been... I think his last victory was at SummerSlam last year. So, and it's Ricochet. So, I'm going Logan Paul.
When was the last time Ricochet won some?
Don't worry. I just play T.I. laughing for no reason at all.
Oh man, I want to go with the black man,
but you're not, because you're not on that wave. You're not.
What wave?
You're not on the black man wave.
Man, chill, bro.
You're not. People want to keep their predictions title, so like you, people scared to go the opposite direction because they want to remain 7-time champion.
Manny, who you think's gonna win?
My boy Rick O'Shea.
This is what I like, man.
Smell me.
Because Manny dumb. I like this is what I like, Manny, right here, man. Right, Manny, man, is the greatest.
I'm gonna go with Logan, man. Fuck it.
Pussy.
I hate niggas. I really do, but it's cool.
I got Christian's picks here too. She's going with,
for the battle royal. Who she got
for the battle royal? She got LA Knight.
Okay.
And for this match, she has Logan Paul.
Okay.
Okay. Right, so that's cool. 1 point for Manny.
All right. Cool. Next up, man. We got the IC title on the line. Gunther defending his title against Drew McIntyre. Eve, this is on you.
I'm 100% rolling with the favorite here, heavy favorite. I'm rolling with Gunther. I think he's going to surpass Pepe Morales. And what's the other nigga? Honky Tonk Man. And his name is not Pepe Morales. It's Pedro Morales. I think he already... I don't know who Pepe Morales is. I made him up.
That sounds like a French frog.
Eve is a sick nigga, y'all.
Yo. Pepe Morales.
Pepe. Shout out
to Pepe,
man.
Pepe.
That be the name. That's what Robert Downey Jr. calls every Puerto Rican.
Who you got, man?
I got my boy Gunna.
I also have Gunther. Sorry, Drusev McIntyre, because it's not going down like that. And who does Chris have?
Chris Ann has Drew McIntyre.
Oh, yes. This is what I like, division, nigga. And I ain't talking about the OVO.
The R&B group.
Yeah, I'm not. Yeah, I like
I've seen them live in concert once. Fire.
I was about to be like, how bad was it?
No, it was legit amazing.
Let's do it, man. Next match, Ronda Rousey versus Shayna Baszler in a MMA rules match. This one is on Manny. What's up?
Question before I pick. Isn't every match a MMA rules match?
No, Manny. Sorry to break that news to you if you haven't found out the difference between MMA and WWE, Manny.
What are the difference between MMA rules and regular WWE rules?
Manny, if you can just watch an MMA match... And
I do out. every Saturday I watch. They got submissions. They got submissions and knockouts, just like the wrestling. I'm picking Shayna Baszler.
The Baze?
The Baze.
I'm going with Shayna Baszler as well. And by the way, they did a build on Monday Night Raw for this, the backstage segments between Shayna and Ronda. And then and those segments made me want to see this match even more. That was the best thing about Raw for me personally, besides the Gable and Gunther match on Raw. But the backstage segments I got between these two was fucking amazing. They did a great job with that. But I got Shayna Baszler going over.
Yeah, I got Shayna also. And so does Chris Ann.
Cool. Cool. And I think this is one of four main events. Yes, we have four main events. This might be a record. I don't know if you guys seen on Raw. They announced four. I know y'all heard of three main events. We have four main events. And this is the first one, man. We have Cody Rhodes versus Brock Lesnar with no stipulation. That was a surprise going into this one. No stipulation. And who is this on? This is on me, right? Yeah. I'm guessing this is on me. Okay. I'm going Cody. We're going to have Cody win in the match to finish this off. I don't know how Cody gets it done, but I'm going Cody Rhodes on this one.
I too want to go with Cody Rhodes.
Now that my question is, does the release of the doc influence this answer?
For us?
That's on you,
yeah. Yeah, no, y'all both picked Cody.
Oh, for me, no. I always thought Cody was gonna win the feud because Cody's the one I have going to challenge Roman in the future. So mm-hmm. we gotta, and he's the one moving the merch. He's the top baby face. You gotta have him win, get over Brock in the feud. So
yeah. The documentary definitely has not influenced my decision. But I do think Cody does need to get a win over Brock. Also, I think this is like the this is going to be like Brock's new feud. Like, you remember how him and Roman was beefing for like 8 years?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like this is like the new like Brock Roman. Since they ran that into the ground. So I think Brock is just going to beef with Cody for like 2 years straight.
Right.
But yeah, I got Cody.
I'll go with Brock.
Oh, I gotta put a new graphic because I see your goals and I'm rolling. I respect it. If I could ask Eve, who does Chris have in this match?
She got Cody.
All right, cool.
Oh yeah, I won.
As we move along right now, and I can just play this drop real quick before I introduce it.
Triple threat.
I can say, yes, we have a triple threat match. It's going down, man, for the WWE Women's Championship. We have Asuka versus Charlotte Flair versus Bianca Belair. And it's on you, Eve.
Well, first thing I want to say is Bianca Belair, you look marvelous. You know what I'm saying? Second thing I want to say is I don't know who wins, man. This is tough because I'm thinking about who eats the pin here. Who taps out? All of these women are too strong to get pinned, too strong to tap. I really don't know. It's probably going to be Bianca.
Bianca winning?
No, Bianca getting pinned or tapped. Because, you know Charlotte damn sure ain't going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like Bianca, they trying to bring her back down to earth a little bit.
So who you got winning? Yeah, see? You threw me for a loop for a second.
I'm going to go Asuka. Asuka got to retain.
Oscar. He got Oscar with the win. Manny, what's up?
I also have Oscar.
I have Charlotte. I have Charlotte winning, and I have Io Sky cashing in.
I like that. I like that.
I think on the SummerSlam card, this was a question I was going to ask y'all after we get done with the card, but do we have a cash in? And it came up right here. I have to say, I honestly think EO cashes in on Charlotte. Once again, it builds up Charlotte as Charlotte gets another title reign under her belt. And once again, someone cashes in on Charlotte. And Charlotte has something to go off of. And I honestly think this is going to lead to Charlotte versus Bianca.
I don't see EO cashing in, though. I feel like we've seen too many cash-ins at SummerSlam to where, like, it loses value. I feel like if we do get a cash-in from EO, it happens on one of the main, like, the weekly shows and not a pay-per-view.
They're teasing it every week.
Mm-hmm.
Too. It's just like, and with this triple threat, I honestly think I could see that happening. You know what I'm saying? I'm probably wrong. More than likely, I'm going to be wrong. But I can see it. I can see it.
Maybe so, maybe she teases a cash in and calls Asuka the title.
I just don't see Asuka. I don't see Asuka just walking out as champion, to be honest with you. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to say that. I got Charlotte with the victory. Eel with the cash in after. And who does Chris have, Eve?
Chris has Asuka.
Mm-hmm. Okay, as we go on, man, we have the World Heavyweight Championship on the line. Seth Rollins versus Finjamin Balor, a.k.a. Pin Balor himself. This is on Manny?
Damian Priest.
Here we go. Cash in, baby. Let's get it.
Yeah, remember what I said earlier about they cash in too much at SummerSlam?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fuck all that shit. And Damian Priest.
Yeah. So you think, wait, hold on. Before we move any further, you think Priest cashes in and makes this a triple threat because you didn't give us an answer between the two?
That's a good question. I would be much more interested if Finn wins and then Damian Priest cashes in on Finn. But that'll probably not happen because that's too cool. So, I don't know. Yeah, triple threat, Damian Priest pins Finn.
I'm rocking it. Wait, so man, okay, so you got Damian Priest.
Mm-hmm. Cody can I put in a choice if Damian Priest doesn't cash?
I mean, the match is between two people.
I'll do Seth, and the bonus points is Damian Priest.
Look, man, this is tougher than. And I expect it. This is tough. This is tougher than I expected. I'm going Seth. I'm gonna go Seth.
Yeah, my fault. Go ahead.
I'm gonna go Seth. I was about to say I could see this match being the cash-in more than the women's match, but no.
Mm-hmm.
I still see the women's match being the more
cash-inable one.
Yeah. But both of these matches is just like, yo, it's a high possibility someone's cashing in. I'ma just go Seth. I'ma just play it safe. I'ma just rock with Seth. So Eve, this is on.
I'm rolling with Seth too. I do feel like Finn should win.
He should.
He deserves it. Mm-hmm. I mean, I feel like it would be a great story, that redemption, but I'm going to go with Seth.
And Chrisanne?
Chrisanne got... she got Roman.
She got Seth, I think.
Yeah, Seth.
Yeah. All right. Chris got Seth. And you know what that leads to, ladies and gentlemen. Our final match of the night. The
The final main event.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. The final main event. The final of the four main events, man. The Tribal Combat for the Undisputed WWE Universal Championship and recognition of Tribal Chief. We got Roman Reigns versus Jey Uso. And who is this on? This might be on me.
Yeah, it is on you. It is on you.
Look, Roman, duh. I'm not stupid.
Believe that graphic. Why does Roman look like, why does he look so black, bro?
Like, literally both of them. Both of them.
Jey is honestly, Jey is kind of this complexion. You know what I'm saying? Almost. Roman,
they got him looking like Morris Chestnut.
Bro, this nigga making Roman look like Tyrese, boy. Like, this nigga, man.
You said this nigga look like Tyrese is fucking.
Bro, crazy. He looks like Digimon Hansen.
Yo, who the fuck?
That's the dude from Never Back Down. Who looks just like Seal?
Yeah, nigga called him Digimon.
All right. That's his name.
Bro. Digimon. I gotta play this drop.
Like, you know what I mean? I've tombstoned a girl.
For no apparent reason at all.
I'm going with, I almost said Jey Uso. Lord. I'm going with Roman Reigns, man.
Nah, just say it.
Nah, I'm going with Roman, bro.
That's what you was about to say. So that count, right?
No.
All right, man. Fuck it. I tried. Manny, who you got?
I'm going with Roman. I'm gonna go on a limb and say Chrisanne is also going with Roman.
Yeah, that was obvious.
Guess what,
man? Pussies.
But, so you pick Jey.
Pussies.
All right, everybody got fucking Roman. Wow, congratulations. You fucking niggers. Yo, oh. I'm gonna give my title back. I'm gonna tell you that. I ain't playing with you fucking weirdo ass niggas. I came to get my title back and I ain't playing with you niggas. Guess what? We here. It's going down Saturday night. We here. It's going down. And I'm going to pull up on the live stream as your new predictions champion. I don't care what nobody's talking about. I don't care what nobody got to say. I don't care. Because what's this drop right here I got to play? Yes, nigga, that's what it is. I don't care. It's going down. Someone's playing in Detroit, nigga. Ford Field, they say it is. Ford Field, I don't know about Detroit. Cade Cunningham, what up? We here. We live. It's going down. That's all I got to say. Saturday, right after SummerSlam, it's going down. Live. Post show, we here. I'm breaking it down brick by brick, and I'm going to let you know the truth about these matches because y'all be lying. Guess what? Fuck your 5-star rating. It's going down. Black Announce Table, we here. I don't give a fuck what nobody got to say. We here.
How do I follow that up? Tune in.
We good, man. That's it. We doing Talk To Me Nice. We not doing Talk To Me Nice.
I ain't doing no fucking. It's one in the morning.
Yeah, we'll do it on Saturday.
Oh, yeah, I'll talk to you on Saturday. I'm going to end like this. Now, let me stop.
And Manny, talk to us, man. What you got to say before we head out?
I still haven't edited the new Last Stop episode like I said I would last week or whatever. It's coming out at some point. I'm tired. I love you guys. Saturday, we're here.
I respect it, man. And with that being said, I can't hit my drop.
I give my all. I give my all.
Check this out, listeners, man. Love y'all. Per usual, it's your boy Cody Drake. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on IG. Follow me on all social media platforms except TikTok. I don't have a TikTok. You know what I'm saying? I don't. But
he doesn't trust China.
I don't speak their language, so I'm cool. Wow. You can follow me on everything, Cody Dre, at Cody Dre, CodiDre. Look, man, as everything goes right, I might have a new audio Dre next week. You know what I'm saying? If my guests come through.
Gable Stevenson is your guest?
You know what? No, Stevenson is not my guess. I'm not you.
Deshaun Watson is your guess?
Ew. Yo, Manny, you got new notifications from Grindr. Please check your notification, bro.
So listen, look, man, you're the one who's trying to get the Pied Piper of R&B on your pod. I don't know.
Look, man, Vlad got an interview with him. And Black gotta put that out. I want to see what the R man gotta say. But look, man, I see what Manny's trying to do. He's trying to detour me from my outro right now. But listeners, I won't let him do that because we have this bond. It's me and y'all. You know what I'm saying? Shouts out to y'all for tuning in, making it this far on this show. Shouts out to my co-host for rocking with us, for being on this stream for this long.
3 hours.
Because that shows y'all how committed they are to y'all. You know what I'm saying? Shouts out to y'all. Love y'all. We'll be right back on Saturday, man. And with that being said, I'm going to holler at y'all then, man.
Cody Dre.
YouTube.com/Black Announce Table. Tap in, subscribe. Patreon.com/Black Announce Table. New words take us up right now. Shouts to the homie T. That joined us, a fellow patron, $20 tier. He joined us.
My guy.
We was talking about some good things, man. We was talking about Messi in Miami. We was talking about that Bud Crawford and Errol Spence fight. We was talking about would you take the Mbappe deal? You know what I'm saying? We was talking some football, too. So if y'all have not tapped in yet, I suggest you do. It's a really good talk for about a solid hour. I realize worst take, Manny really does pull up with the worst possible take because my boy Manny said Baker Mayfield is an underrated quarterback in the league.
Very underrated.
That right there just made me want to jump out of my chair, bro. So tap in to Worst Take on Patreon right now. Yeah, go sub. Instagram, Twitter, Threads, TikTok, Facebook, you know where to find us. Black Announce Table and all of that. TTM, man, we're going to make sure we get y'all on Saturday. I may or may not be here. I don't know. I might pull up for the post show. Most likely. I'm like 85% sure. My man's is having an engagement party, so I'm going to see. You feel me? I'm going to have to be two places at once, but you know your boy don't let y'all down. Mouse soon come. I spoke to Mouse yesterday. We're trying to work the schedule out. So, yeah. Everything is copacetic, man. Shouts to the gang. We'll see y'all soon tomorrow.
Before we go, two things. One, shout out to KP, who's about to edit this almost 3-hour video and pod and everything like that. Jesus Christ. And two, Eve, have you not had a hat on this whole time?
Bro, I have not had a hat. I have not had a haircut in 3 weeks.
Damn.
Wow.
I look ridiculous. Honestly, I don't know if I want to grow my hair and get braids or just shave it off and be bald.
Damn.
So, you know.
That's me, right? I don't know if I want to get curls or just get a number one on the top.
Damn.
Life. Spin a wheel. Saturday we're going to spin a wheel to find out the fate of Manny's hair.
We're not going to be here, but we're going to spin the wheel.
I heard it here first. He locked in. He tapped in. 294. We out, man.